The thing is, I'm just trying to understand the aging timers in the LSA. So once a router one generates an LSA, LSA one, obviously it will have an aging timer in it.
Correct.
So that aging timer, obviously that LSA has been taken by probably router two.
Mm-hmm.
But that timer in the LSA and the timer in the LSDB, I mean, do they synchronize or what is the situation?
Mm-hmm. Let's suppose we have R1 and we have R2. Okay. So let's suppose R1 wants to create a new LSA. Okay. So it will generate LSA, or we can say that will send your LSU, link state update, right? So in LSU, okay, we have LSU, LSR, LSU, LSA, right? That is LS acknowledge. Okay. This is your link state.
Advertisement.
Yeah. Okay. This is your LSA 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever LSA we have, whatever update we have. So in the LSU, yeah, I will be having LSA. And in LSA, I will be having an age. The age will start from 0. Okay. Let's suppose I will send a packet to you. Okay. So I will say age is 0. Now you will keep counting 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. If once R2 will receive the packet, the age is 0, it will install in the database and it will keep running plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1 after every 1 second. Right. Once this timer goes to 1800, automatically R1 will create a new this LSA again with the same age 0 and will flood to R2. Again, it will start from 0, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. Again, keep counting. Let's suppose if did not receive after 1800 seconds. So what it will do? It will run the timer till 3600 seconds. Okay. And if this timer, till this timer, R2, if did not receive any update, so it will flush this LSA. That's it.
The LSDB isn't it? But I'm just getting confused between the LSA age timer and the LSDB timer,
right? Correct.
So LSDB, yes, that is right.
For the states, only for the first time, the routers exchange the LSDB. Okay. That DB.
My
descriptor.
Okay. Okay. Let's assume that we have three or four LSAs to keep the understanding simple.
Okay.
So let's assume that R2 has received one LSA at point R2 has.
Okay.
LSA one from I'll start from the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
From R2, R1 is receiving an LSA. Let's assume at 12 o'clock. Okay.
Okay.
And obviously, R2 में वो LSA timer चालू हो जाता है.
Correct.
Right.
Yes.
Again, R2 is also receiving another LSA from R3.
Okay.
Let's assume the LSA received from R3 to R2. R2 leta hai wo LSA. And let's assume that the LSA from R3, which is in R2, the timer is 12:05. 5 minute ke baad shuru hua, the timing.
Okay.
So what I'm trying to understand is each and every individual LSA in the LSDB of R2, the timers, do they run independently or
yes,
in a synchronized manner?
No, independently. For this LSA, the timer will be different. For this LSA, the timer will be different, 100%.
And on top of that, there is an LSDB in which the LSAs are present, and LSDB has another timer.
No, look, basically what we have to memorize for this one, each LSA can have a different timer. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
So on R1, we have LSA1. I received LSA1 at 12 o'clock. Okay. I received LSA2 at 12:05. Okay. I received LSA3 again at, let's suppose, 12:10. Okay. So for each, first of all, if I did not receive any update, this will get removed at 1, will flush. Okay. This will flush this time, and this will flush
1 time. Okay. So, yeah, this is a little clarity. because my so my, and obviously all these timers are present in another timer which is an LSDB, isn't it?
No, never. We just have the database, that's it.
So what database ko timer hi nahi hai?
No, yeah, koi aisa timer nahi hai, right? Ki database koi log se timer hai. The timer okay, is so, LSA, not for the full database.
Okay, okay. वही था मेरा doubt, ये कैसा चलेगा? And and okay, so let's assume that obviously the LSA one which has been received at R2 is at 1 o'clock. So R1 probably might have generated the LSA at 11:59. So again at after like what do you call 12:29, it will start. It will generate another LSA and send it to R2.
Yes.
Correct.
Yes, all the routers will generate LSA after every 1800 seconds. 100%.
Okay. Yeah. Well, that's clear. No, I thought ये timers के बारे में थोड़ा confused हो रहा था. क्या हो रहा
है? Okay. So once we start CCI, so we will be having other timers as well.
Okay.
Almost here.
Last one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay. Last question. let's assume R1, same thing, same scenario, R1 and R2. Obviously, the LSA1 which has been sent to R2, let's assume the sequence number is 1, right? And sequence number is 1 and it keeps sending the LSA every 30 minutes with the higher sequence number.
Yes.
Right? Let's assume there is another router, R3, which is sending LSA with a lower sequence number. Is that possible?
No, never. Let's suppose,
R1 can actually send an LSA with a lower sequence number than the sequence number
that is possible.
R2 has?
That is not
possible at all.
Yeah.
Okay.
Only in one condition possible. Only one single condition that is possible. Okay. Let's suppose the first start from 0x00001. Like this. Okay.
Okay.
This sequence number goes to 0x9999 or maybe that is FFFF. Okay. Now, once they will generate the next update, now the next update will be having the lower sequence number than 0000. Okay. Only this is the condition. In that case, it will start from 0 again.
Okay.
But that is not possible.
But generally,
this update, because all F, it means if I talk about F, this is like n numbers of time, right?
Okay. No, I understand that is clear. Okay, that is very clear. And that's it. My OE doubts. I'm still going through this OSPF thing. It is not, it's like a big monster. Anyway, that's it. I have no doubts anymore.
Sir, R1 se jab R2 ki taraf jab अपडेट जाएगा आफ्टर 180 सेकंड हो जाएगा
18 सेकंड
हां उसके बाद सर नए से हो जाएगा टाइमर स्टैंड
हां बिल्कुल टाइमर जीरो से स्टार्ट होगा यस
100% सर देन फिर से भेजेगा ना वो 1800 सेकंड के बाद
यस
और वन तो फिर सर
उसके बाद वो सेंड करता रहेगा उसको
सर फिर 3600 तक कब पहुंचेगा क्योंकि वो R1
अगर R1 डाउन हो चुका है या बीच में कोई इशू आ चुका है तो R2 के पास वो टाइम जाएगा 3600 तक और उसके बाद वो फ्लश होगा
ओके
लेट्स सपोज R1 इज नॉट एबल टू रिसीव द अपडेट सो इन दैट कंडीशन इट विल रन द टाइमर टिल 3600 सेकंड्स
सर मतलब अगर R1 डाउन नहीं हुआ कभी तो फिर ये हर 1800 सेकंड के बाद अपडेट होता है
यस करेक्ट
ओके
ये रीसेट होता है ना
यस आफ्टर एवरी 1800
ओके But it will not even go till 1800, right? Because obviously, before it hits the full 1800 seconds, you should be getting an LSA from R1, and that will reset it before reaching
correct.
Number.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so let's start BGP. Border gateway protocol. So any idea about this one? What is BGP? Why we use BGP? Why do not we use like OSPF? Why this is the best protocol between ISP and customer?
Different AS number?
We can use different AS number in the case of EIGRP as well. Even in EIGRP, we can run multiple AS number on single router, but in BGP, we can just run a single AS.
BGP, you can run a single AS?
Only one single AS we can run on a single router.
But BGP can talk between different autonomous systems, isn't it?
Even EIGRP can communicate between different AS using a distribution, right?
ज्यादा नहीं पता है सर, सीसीएनए में बहुत कम सीखा है.
आपने पढ़ा सीसीएनए में कभी बीजीपी?
हाँ थोड़ा बहुत पढ़ा है. It is within the syllabus. बोलता है कि the syllabus in CCNA is BGP is used only for configuring the edge routers to the ISP.
Correct.
So that is what we learned, and the theory says BGP actually connects between different service providers.
Yes. Okay. So let's start. So basically, the first feature if I talk about BGP. Okay, if I talk about the redistribution, so we can have issues of suboptimal routing, remember? If I will talk about IGP, so in the IGP, to make a communication between two different AS, what I need a redistribution, correct? So in that case, we can have issues of suboptimal routing, correct? But in BGP, once we start using BGP, we cannot have this issue. Okay. So if we have BGP, we can advertise any route, learn via any protocol. Okay. In BGP. So in BGP, let's suppose we have a single router R1 that is getting some routes from RIP protocol, getting some routes from EIGRP, getting some routes from OSPF. And now what I want to advertise those routes into BGP. So in this point, what we know, the only one feature we have, that is redistribution, correct? But using redistribution, we can have issues of suboptimal routing, right? But once we start using BGP, we can advertise any route learned via any protocol in BGP. It means we'll not be having any issue, no issue of suboptimal routing. Okay, this is clear, Chaitanya?
Huh. Okay. So, kal topics. जो आप बोले रिगार्डिंग द VRF, इंस्टेड ऑफ द सेंट्रल राउटर वेयर वी टर्न ऑन द फंक्शनैलिटी ऑफ अ VRF, कैन वी यूज बीजीपी देयर?
वी यूज VRF विद बीजीपी ऑलवेज. ओके, बिकॉज़ इन दैट कंडीशन वी नीड टू परफॉर्म द रिडिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, राइट? बट वंस वी स्टार्ट यूजिंग बीजीपी विद VRF, so in that case, no need to perform the redistribution. Even we can advertise the routes without redistribution. Okay, so that is a part of like CCI. Once we start CCI, I will show you like how we can use VRF with BGP. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
So we can advertise any route learned via any protocol in BGP. So no issues of suboptimal routing. But here, to advertise routes from different protocol. To different protocol, we need redistribution, correct? Right? So in this case, we need a redistribution Any doubt to this point?
No.
Okay. The third thing, in IGP, using network command. Okay, just one question for you before completing this line. Let's suppose, let me draw a diagram. Let's suppose we have a router. Okay. In the routing table, I'm getting some routes. B101.1.1, B101.2, B101.3/32/32/32. OSPF 101.1.4/32, OSPF 101.1.5/32, and some connected route 1.1.1.6/32, connected route 1.1.1.7/32. Okay, so I'm getting these routes, and this is your R1. Okay, so this R1 is having another connection, let's suppose to R2. Okay, and in between we are running, let's suppose RIP protocol we are running in between 1 and 2. So once on R1, let's say we are running here RIP protocol. Okay, so in between 1 and 2, or maybe on R1, okay, once I will run the command network 10000. Okay, so in this condition, how many routes R2 will receive? I will run this network command network 1.0000. So how many routes R2 will receive?
R1 pe.
R1 pe maine kya kiya, network 1000 maine command chalai hai. Okay, and this is the routing table of R1. So question kya hai, R2 kaun kaun se route receive karega?
Two.
Only two. Perfect. Only it will receive only two routes, that is 1.1.1.6 and 1.1.1.7, correct? Now, and these routes, what I need a redistribution feature, that's it, correct? Without redistribution we cannot receive the routes in the RIP protocol. But if in between I will configure BGP, so using only network command, okay, I can inject all of these routes, those are present in my table. Okay, so in the BGP, using network command, we can inject any route that is present in routing table into BGP table. Okay, so my routing table ke andar koi route present hoga, main use advertise karwa sakta hu kiske andar BGP ke andar, without using a distribution, only using the network command we can inject that route into the BGP table. Okay,
so can you actually show those networks again?
Yeah,
I mean the question pooch hai, all the EIGRP and the OSPF routes pura chale jaate network lagaya to.
Yes, अगर मैं network command यहाँ चलाई, so all the routes will get injected. But कैसे inject होंगे, क्या process होगा, वो आगे बात करेंगे.
I mean, just to get clarity, तो but okay, so R2 को सब.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. It will receive all the routes using the network command only in BGP. तो बीजेपी ने कभी ये चेक नहीं करता कि वो मेरा कनेक्टेड राउट है या इनडायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड है, वो सिर्फ क्या चेक करता है, इफ दैट राउट इज बेस्ट इन माय राउटिंग टेबल, सो आई विल एडवर्टाइज द राउट टू द नेबर, दैट्स इट. ओके, वो हमेशा चेक करता है कि आप राउटिंग टेबल, इफ दैट राउटर इज हैविंग द राउट इन द राउटिंग टेबल, यस वी कैन एडवर्टाइज टू एनी नेबर, डजंट मैटर दैट इज रन बाय एनी प्रोडक्ट.
ओके
ओके,
in IGP we just have hop count. Okay, and metric and cost. So metric in the case of EIGRP, hop count in the case of RIP, right? And cost in the case of OSP. So we just have these things to manipulate the path, right? Right or wrong? So we just have these attributes, these things to manipulate the path, but in VGP. Total we have 11 path attributes to manipulate the path. Clear? So here total number of attributes we have 11. So using 11 attributes we can manipulate the path, but in IGP we just have single attribute to manipulate the path. Okay. Chetan, this is clear to you? Hello.
Ah, sir, clear.
We cannot change the decision of another router, correct? So let's suppose we have five routers in my single domain, and the other domain is having five routers. So using my domain, I cannot change the decision for another domain, correct? Right? Let's suppose we have two protocols. One is EIGRP, is BGP, or we can say, let's suppose we have single protocol, okay? And we have 10 routers in the domain in fully meshed topology, okay? So in that case, we cannot change the decision for another router, okay? But in BGP, using path attribute, we can change decision for another AS also. कैसे बात करते हैं कि डायग्राम क्या बनेगा. Let's suppose this is your ISP 1 and this is your ISP 2. Okay. So someone is here that want to access your devices. Okay. Or want to install some software, want to download and like anything. Okay. So what you want whenever your users will access anything to the internet, that should go to this AS. And whenever any of other user that is not in my AS that want to access my domain, or if I will get the reply, so I should get the reply from this AS. So yes, we can control this decision. Okay. It means only I will do some changes here only, and this that effect will be here. Okay. It means once I will run some commands here, this PC will start sending the packet out to this interface. Okay, using this IS. Clear?
Okay.
So this decision we can do only in the case of BGP, not in the case of IGP. Okay. In the IGP, we can change the decision for me. Let's suppose we are running OSP affairs. So I can change the decision. I can use this interface, or I can use this interface to get the to send the traffic. Correct? But in BGP, we can change the decision for my own AS and can change for another AS as well. Okay. You clear? Eh?
Okay.
Any doubt to this point?
No, sir.
So these are the things that are like these are the differences in between IGP and BGP. So it's better to use BGP in between customer and IS. Okay. So Chaitanya, any doubt at this point? Please read the lines. If you have not, we can discuss.
इसका एडी कितना है?
एडी हम बात करेंगे आगे, डोंट वरी. ओके, बिकॉज़ अलग-अलग एडी है, मुझे कांसेप्ट समझाना पड़ेगा. सो बेसिकली वी हैव टू एडी हियर. 20 इनटू आगे बात करेंगे कब आएगी 20 कब आएगी 200
नहीं सर
एवरीथिंग इज क्लियर
हाँ सर
So BGP, it's a layer 7 protocol. Okay. So in BGP, we can configure direct and indirect neighborship. If I talk about IGP, we cannot configure indirect neighborship. But yes, in BGP, we can configure direct and indirect neighborship. Okay. It is a classless protocol. You know what is this classless, right? By default, summarization is disabled, like AIGRP. Okay, and it use TCP with port number 179. Okay, so basically, this protocol BGP use a feature that is TCP. So why we use TCP? BGP use TCP to make the connection reliable. Okay. So before BGP, let's suppose we have two routers, they want to form the BGP session. So before BGP session, they will try to form the TCP session. If they both are successful to form the TCP session, they will initiate BGP. Okay. So if we have two routers, they want to form BGP session. So before initiating BGP, they will try to form a TCP connection between routers. If they successfully form TCP, then they start the BGP process. Okay. So if they are successful, so yes, they will start the BGP process. Otherwise, they will never start the BGP process. Okay. This is clear. Yeah, this line is clear. So we have two types of neighborship here. One is IBGP. The another one is EBGP. Okay. For the IBGP, the AD will be 200. For the EBGP, the AD will be 20 always. Okay. Any doubt to this point?
No, sir. Sir, ये layer 7 protocol बोले आप?
Yes.
वो थोड़ा समझने में थोड़ा मुश्किल हो रहा क्योंकि generally when we go with the routing protocols.
Yes.
I mean, the thing is generally everyone uses IP and then they have their own special protocol so that, you know, the routes are distributed and all that.
Correct.
Ye layer 7 hua to
dekho,
what ye, happens at
ye a... protocol, haan. Ye protocol dekho, sirf use hoga aapke route exchange karwane ke liye basically. Dekho, agar hum baat kare ki maine sirf BGP use kar rakha and I'm not using any other protocol. Okay. So, na BGP karta. So, before BGP, underlay protocol should be any protocol, should be IGP. Okay. Agar underlay IGP, then only we can run over IGP. Okay. We can run BGP over IGP. So, pehle aapka IGP hi chalega to for the reachability. Okay. कि लेट्स सपोज मेरे पास 10 राउटर हैं, ओके, नाउ व्हाट आई वांट टू फॉर्म द नेबरशिप इन बिटवीन राउटर 1 एंड राउटर 10. सो इन दैट कंडीशन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड हैव दिस प्रोटोकॉल आईजी प्रोटोकॉल. ओके, नाउ ओवर द आईजीपी आई विल रन बीजीपी एंड बीजीपी वी यूज जस्ट टू एक्सचेंज द राउट्स. ओके, सो इट मींस दैट इज वी आर यूजिंग अ प्रोटोकॉल दैट इज जस्ट यूजिंग टू एक्सचेंज द राउट्स, दैट्स इट. ओके, नथिंग एल्स. दैट्स व्हाई वी से दिस इज अ लेयर 7 प्रोटोकॉल और रीचेबिलिटी प्रोटोकॉल, दैट्स इट. ओके
ओके ओके,
मतलब बीजीपी आईजीपी के बगैर नहीं चलेगा,
नहीं चल सकता, नेवर. चला सकते हैं सिर्फ एक टास्क करने के लिए, बट इन द रियल सिनेरियो वी नेवर यूज बीजीपी अलोन, नेवर नेवर.
ओके
ओके, वी हैव टू यूज आईजीपी. अगर मैं बात करूं आईएसपी की, तो कोई भी आईएसपी विदाउट आईजीपी काम नहीं कर सकता. आईजीपी इज मैंडेट बिफोर रनिंग बीजीपी. ओके, बिकॉज देखो हम बीजीपी ना पूरे कोर में नहीं चलाते. लेट्स सपोज एक आईएसपी आपके पास, उसके पास 50 राउटर है. Now on all the 50 routers, I will never configure BGP, never, because काफी हो जाएगी हर किसी के पास. All the 50 routers will be having lakhs of route, right? But we don't want those things. Okay, so we'll discuss one by one. Okay, क्या आएगा क्या नहीं आएगा issues and why we use BGP और features आएंगे इसके आगे, सब clear होते जाएंगे one by one. Okay.
Okay.
Chetan, any doubt at this point?
नहीं sir, ठीक है, clear है.
So it has two protocols, two neighborship type, that is IBGP and EBGP. So IBGP, it means if both routers are using same AS, it means that is your IBGP. If both routers are using different AS, it means that is EBGP connection. Okay, so the router will identify the AS number. If the AS number is same, that is your IBGP neighbor. If the AS number is different, that is your EBGP neighbor. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So we also have some timers. Okay. So these are your keep alive timer. So first we have 60 seconds. And the dead timer is 180 seconds. Okay, so 60 is keep live. In every 60 seconds, they will exchange that keep live to each other just to inform that I am up. If they did not receive any packet till 180 seconds, so the neighbors will be down. Okay, clear? Yeah?
Sir, मतलब 60 seconds के बाद भी वो keep live भेजता रहे.
After every 60 second, yes. जैसे 60 second पूरा हमें एक पैकेट दोबारा, like hello and that timer, okay? यहाँ पे हमने नाम use like that से, okay? कोई doubt यहाँ तक?
नहीं sir, नहीं sir.
So the timers here we have, one is keep alive, one is dead, hold we can say, so that is 60 and 180. So about the timers negotiation. If let's suppose R1 and we have two routers and R2, okay, so R2 is using 60 and 180, okay, and here on R1 I have configured a new timer that is 30 and let's suppose 90. Okay, so what will happen here, they never check the timers, like they never check the parameters, the hello parameters using the timers. What they will do, they both will negotiate lower timer. Okay, these both routers will negotiate the lower timer. So it means once I will run BGP in between these two routers, what will happen, these R2 will start using 30 and 90. Okay, this clear?
Yes. Oh, sir.
Okay, so okay, this one is clear. Now the AS number concept. So here we have a new thing, that is AS number, like EIGRP. Okay. So in BGP we have AS number concept. We have two types of AS number. The old version of IO support only 16-bit Okay, the new version of IO supports 16 bit and 32 bit as well. Okay, so first of all, 16 bit, it's a decimal format. A 32 bit number can be a decimal or a dotted decimal, like dot and the another 16 bit. So these are your first 16 bits. Okay, and then these are your another 16 bits. Okay, like this we use. Okay, let's suppose here if I'll assign AS number 100. Okay, so how I will assign here, that will be, you can assign 100 directly or you can say that is 0.100. Okay, like this. Clear?
Okay.
So basically we have a range. So if I'll talk about 16 bits, so here we can have 16 and here we can have 16. So the range will be same. 16 bit, it means we can have total, we can have 65536. It means it will start from 0 to 65535, right? Correct? It will,
yes.
655, sorry, it will start from 0 to 65535. Now 0 and 65535, these both are reserved. This one is also reserved. So now from 1 to 64495. So these are the public address range. Okay. Then 64496 to 64511. These are again reserved for documentation. Okay. Then the remaining 64512 to 64565534. These are the range. Okay. Any doubt?
No.
So like IP address, we have this range. We have some addresses are reserved, some addresses are public, and some addresses are private. Okay. So whenever ISP will use, ISP will always use the public range, and whenever the customer will use, the customer can use a private AS as well for the local customers. Okay. Customer to customer, so we use a private range. Okay.
The public one, is it assigned by IANA as well?
Yes, yes, yes. Like IP address. So now how we can say, let's suppose if I'll talk about only 16 bit AS number. So let's suppose if I will say the AS number is 100, or if I'll say the AS number is 64512. So we can say, okay, this one is your private, right? And if I'll talk about this one, so yes, this one is my public address, correct? What will happen if I want to, I will get a question like, you have to use a public address and private address in the case of 32 bit. So let's suppose I will write a task. Let's suppose 100.64512. And I will ask, this is your private range or public range? Basically, this is your 32 bit AS number, right? Yeah, but 32 bit AS number. So how we will identify that is my public range or private range? Any idea?
No, sir.
We always check last 16 bit to identify AS number always. Okay. Clear? We always check last 16 bit to identify the AS number. So it means this is the private room. Clear?
Yes.
Example दे सकते क्या 16 bit और 32 bit का just you know some random numbers how the AS number is like.
If I talk about, let's suppose 16 bits. Okay, so we can have 100, we can have 64512, we can have 5555, like this we can have. Okay.
Okay, 32 bit वाला.
हाँ, 32 bit में होगा. Let's suppose 32 bit. So we can like 100.100, okay. 100.64512, 64512.100, 555.100. So we have to check the last octet. So this is the last octet, belongs to your public. This belongs to your private. This belongs to your public again, last octet. Right. Again. public. Okay.
I mean, last chapter, is that in a hex format? That's not in a hex
no,
format.
No, no, no. This is your dotted decimal format.
Okay.
16-bit we have to verify. Okay.
Okay. Just before the dot, we verify whether it is public or private. Yes. I mean, after the dot. Sorry. After
the dot.
Yeah. Okay. TJ. Now it's clear.
Sorry, I was on mute. Okay, so router ID should be unique. That timer can be different, can be same. Okay, capabilities. So we have IPv4, we have IPv6, we have IPv4 multicast and VPNv4 as well. So using the capabilities, they will check the open parameters. Let's suppose we have two routers, R1, R2. R1 is configured for IPv4, R2 is configured for IPv6. they will negotiate open packet. Do we have the same capability? If yes, they will form the neighborship. Otherwise, they will not form the neighborship. Okay. That is clear. So this is your open packet content. Okay. They will send the open message to each other. And if they find everything is correct, so they will form the neighborship. Otherwise, they will not form the neighborship. Never.
Up open repeaters.
Open packet, yeah. अब देखो ओपन पैकेट ना सिर्फ हेलो पैकेट की तरह है, ओके कि हमारे पास लेट्स सपोज एक हेलो पैकेट है इन ईआई जेआरपी या फिर बात करो ओएस पे, क्योंकि जो पैरामीटर वहां चेक करवा रहे हैं एग्जैक्टली सेम थिंग हियर वी हैव, ओके लाइक पहले जाएगा एस नंबर, कैन बी डिफरेंट कैन बी सेम, अगर डिफरेंट है तो वो आपकी ईबीजीपी है, अगर सेम है दैट इज योर आईबीजीपी, राइट?
यस,
ओके. Now we have router ID that should be unique, because agar do router form karenge neighborship, the router ID should be unique, because router exchange karenge unki sath unki router ID bhi aati hai. The dead timer, they negotiate the dead timer capabilities ke upar hi depend hoga sab kuch ki wo IP
neighborship. Dead timer kya
hai? Dead timer is your like keep alive timers, right? Like 16180, remember?
Okay sir.
Kya dekh 60 second hai ek, aapka 180 second hai, wo timers exchange kar rahe hain yahan pe. Okay,
yes sir.
Now, then last we have capabilities ki wo neighborship form karna chahte hain IPv4 ke andar ya fir IPv6 ke andar, that's it. IPv4 multicast hai, IPv6 multicast hai. So what they want to form, that's it. Okay, ki wo kis neighbor ke liye kis address family ke liye kaam karna chahte hain, that's it.
Okay,
doubts ke andar?
No sir.
Hi sir.
Okay, now what is keep alive? Basically keep alive, again though, those timers we use once open parameter are same. So if both router detect like both the parameters are correct, now they will start sending the keep alive to each other. Okay, notification. If the neighborship comes up or goes down, okay, if the neighborship comes up or goes down, they will send notification to each other. Clear? That is a notification and the update packet. So first time they both will send a null update to each other. We cannot say null update, बस एक कहानी है इसके अंदर क्या कि एक पैकेट जाता है, अपडेट का पैकेट जाता है without any information, okay? Only for the first time, okay? So first time they both will send a null update to each other, and then once we add a new route, it will exchange the update. And update कैसे exchange होंगे इसके अंदर? Only partial. Let's suppose मैंने एक route add किया, so it will send 1.1.1.1 only. Let's suppose मैंने एक route remove किया, it will send only 1.1.1. Okay? Full भी send करता है.
अरे,
tell me.
अरे null update reliability के लिए?
नहीं, reliability पहले TCP check कर चुके हैं. सिर्फ एक packet है वो exchange कर रहे हैं आपस में, that's it.
Okay.
Because reliability के लिए यहाँ पे TCP use हो रहा है. Okay? सिर्फ normal update packet है, that's it. कि वो बता रहे कि मेरे पास कोई route नहीं है अभी.
Okay.
The neighborships, are they always point to point? I mean, because in EIGRP and OSPF, we see
always, okay. Always this neighborship will be static. Always.
Oh, it's a static one.
Hmm.
Okay, so I thought you know, two routers will discover each other and then they form a neighborship like EIGRP or OSPF.
No, never. So basically, here, neighbor command. Okay, so here we do not have that feature in the CCI. Yes, we will discuss how they can form the dynamic neighborship. Okay, but dynamic is nothing in BGP. Even the CCI, you will think once we start the dynamic neighborship, that is nothing, because if I talk about dynamic, okay, so in the dynamic as well, one end should be configured with static commands. Okay, if I talk OSPF and RIP, so in that case we can use network command on both ends, correct? They both will auto negotiate, but in the case of BGP, The if I talk about static neighbors, yes, both the neighbors should have the neighbor command. If I talk about dynamic, one single neighbor should have the static configuration. Okay.
It means okay. So even for that, one static configuration needs to be done. Okay.
Yes. Yes. Clear. And this is a unicast protocol, not a multicast. So this protocol never use any multicast addresses. It always send the packet out to the neighbor directly. Okay.
So ab tak jo bhi bataya, like the keep alives, the everything is unicast, and that yes. operates at an application layer.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay.
So any doubt in the messages?
Nice.
I think this is clear, right?
Nice.
Okay. So right now we will discuss. Just give me 1 minute. Good evening. Good evening. Okay, so now what we can discuss, okay, the states. Okay, let's discuss the states. Okay, so in the BGP, we have some neighbor states. So one is idle. The second one is connect. The third is active. The fourth is open send. The fifth is open confirm. The sixth is establish. Okay, so we have six states. It is clear?
Yes.
Okay, now. First, we'll start from idle. Okay. Okay, the messages are clear to both of you. Because look here, once we start the states, again, we will be having these messages. So I will tell you like in what state the routers will access this packet, the router will access this packet, the router will access this packet, or the router will access this packet. Okay.
Yes.
Because the message should be clear. Okay, then we can discuss the state. So first is idle, the second one is connect, the third one is active, open send, open confirm, and establish. Now, okay, do you know the feature of sparing tree states? Remember? The sound knowledge only.
Uh-huh.
Like basically we have disabled listening, learning, blocking, and forwarding, right? So in the they do the election. So if a interface winner is a winner of election, so that will come in the learning state. Otherwise, the port will go in the blocking state, right?
Huh.
Do you remember this thing?
Huh.
Okay, perfect. So that is common here. Okay, let's start first of all the idle. So we have three conditions. Okay, first of all, router is not having any active interface. So this is your first condition where we can have the idle state. Okay, कि अगर उस router के पास कोई भी active interface नहीं है तो वो router ही choose नहीं कर पाएगा. Reason क्या है इसका? Router will not be able to choose router ID. Okay. If a router is not able to use the router ID, the device will never in the process and the state will always remains in the idle state. Okay. That is a common. Second thing. Router does not have any active route in the routing table to reach neighbor. It means the routers are not able to send the packet out. In that condition as well, the state will be idle. Okay. So, देखो अगर route नहीं होगा, so the routers cannot exchange the packet. To each other, clear? So this is the second condition, the third condition. Chetan, any doubt, bro?
No, sir. No, no doubts. I'm just listening.
No, sir.
Now, the third condition. Let's suppose I am having a router ID. I have a route to reach neighbor. The third condition. Router is not the neighbor router. Neighbor router is not configured with neighbor command. Okay, is clear?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt to this point?
Yes, sir.
So only these in these three conditions we can have a neighborship in the ideal state. Okay, so what I will do, I will connect two routers and will show all of these things. Okay.
Yes,
I think these three lines are clear, right?
Yes.
So if the neighbor is not configured with the neighbor command, so what will happen over there? R1 is configured, so R1 will send TCP SYN packet to neighbor, but neighbor is not having neighbor command, so it will send reset packet to the neighbor. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Reset, because the neighbor is not having any neighbor command, so it will say no, I don't have this neighbor, so just reset the session. Okay.
Yes.
Clear. So as I told you before, BGP, these routers will try to form a TCP session. If they are successful, so yes, they will negotiate the BGP packets. Otherwise, they will never negotiate the BGP packets. Okay. Interface F0 by Z. Router BGP 100, neighbor 12002, remote AS is 100. So like this, we always configure the commands. First of all, we have to assign the AS number and then the neighbor command with the remote AS 100. So whatever AS number we have, the neighbor, so we have to assign here. Then enter. Do show IP BGP summary. So this is the command to check the neighborship status. Look here. Right now the state is idle. Reason, because right now the router is not able to pick a router ID, so this router cannot start the BGP process. Clear?
But uske paas active interface to hai na?
No, maine abhi tak koi ek interface banaya hi nahi. Look here, right? All the interface okay. And shut down state. So router BGP question mark. So as I told you, we can use a decimal number. We can also use a dotted decimal number, right? And this your YY represent your public and private AS numbers. Okay.
Okay.
So now let's configure the commands. Interface F0/0 address 12001255000. Non share down loopback 0 IP address 1.1.1.255.255.255. Router BGP 100. Neighbor. Let's suppose 2.2.2.2.255.255.255.255. Sorry. After neighbor, we have to assign the remote ace. So whatever ace number that you're using, so that is using 100. Enter. Okay, so right now we have configured neighbor command with 2.2.2.2. Remote ace is 100, correct? Now, let me capture the link.
But we are not running any other IGPs or between the two.
Yes,
routers.
Yes, that's why. That is the issue. Because if we do not have any reachability, right? Or if I don't have any route to reach the neighbor, the BGP will never come up. So look here, the router is not sending any packet out, correct? Reason, do show IP route to 2.2.2.2. Network node in table. It means first of all, I don't have any route to reach 2.2.2.2. So in that condition as well, the state will be idle. Clear?
Yes.
So let me configure some addresses here as well. 0/0. Address 12002255000. No shut loopback 0 IP address 2.2.2.2.255.255.255. Why they are sending this packet? Reason behind this packet?
They are checking for duplicate IP.
Perfect. So router EAGRPU. Okay, again I'll ask the question. Okay. Network 000. Router EAGRPU 1 network 000. We should get a route here. Route. Just let me check something. Okay, so right now, okay, do show IP route. So yes, I'm having a route to reach neighbor 2.2.2.2. And as I told you, look here, I'm sending a packet out to neighbor 2.2.2.2, and that is your SYN packet. You can see this is a SYN packet, and I'm getting the reset packet, right? So I'm getting a reset from the neighbor that I don't have this protocol or I don't have this neighbor available on this router, correct? It is clear. So the device is sending. Right now, what is happening here? The router is R1 is sending a packet out, correct? With a port number 179. And the router is checking, the neighbor is checking this port number. I don't have any service on this port number, correct? So I will reply with a reset packet. Clear? It's available. So if I'm not having any neighbor, I'm not having the service, I will send the reset information, correct?
Yes.
उसके पास अवेलेबल ही नहीं है उस नेबर के लिए राइट सो वो क्या करेगा सेंड करेगा रीसेट पैकेट इज दैट क्लियर इवन इन दिस कंडीशन स्टेट विल बी आइडल डू शो आईपी बीजीपी समरी यू कैन सी सो ओनली इन दीस थ्री कंडीशंस वी कैन हैव द स्टेट आइडल ओके क्लियर
हां ओके सर
So this is your idle state. Okay. We have the fourth conditions as well, but we'll discuss in the CCI. Okay. So these are the common things that we can have in the idle state. Okay. So if we are having idle, so only these three conditions will be responsible for the idle state. Okay.
Okay.
Yes. Now the second condition. Let's suppose both the neighbors are correct. Everything is configured. The second state will be connect. In this state, both routers will try to form TCP session, or we can say they will run TCP three-way handshake. Okay. Now, if handshake is successful, so they will directly jump in open send state. Okay, so if the TCP three-way handshake is successful, so they will directly jump in the open send. If they face any issue, so they will stuck in active state. Okay. So in this condition, if they face any issues in the connect state, okay, in the TCP three-way handshake, so they will stuck in active here. Okay. Stuck in active state. So the after connect, what we have active state. So they will go in the active state and will stuck for some time. Clear?
Okay.
This is like your learning state in the parent tree. So in the learning, if the election is successful, so they will come in the learning state. Otherwise, they will come in the blocking state. So here as well, if the TCP three-way handshake is successful, so they will directly jump in into the open send state. Otherwise, they will stuck in the active state. Okay. Now, the third state is active. They face with the same line, if they face any issues while doing three-way handshake, so they will come in this state. Okay. And then after some time, they will again start from idle state. Okay. Again, like they will start from idle, idle, connect. Again, if they come in active, again, they will start from idle, connect, like this. Okay.
Okay.
This is clear. Chetan.
Bas aise hi follow kar raha hu sir. Bahut zyada ho gaya.
Dekho nahi, agar aaj ke liye zyada hai to mujhe batao, main yahan pe stop kar dunga. Because agar samajh mein nahi aaya to padhne ka fayda nahi hai.
बहुत ज्यादा हो गया सर.
ओके, सो अभी क्या मानो कि हमने सिर्फ क्या किया, मैसेज किए. सो आप सिर्फ कहां तक रिवाइज करना, मैसेज तक रिवाइज करना. टुमारो अगेन विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द स्टेट्स. ओके,
तो ये स्टेट्स आर सिमिलर टू द ओएसपीएफ का सेवन स्टेट है ना,
लाइक दैट. यस, यस, लाइक दैट, करेक्ट.
ओके, चलो ठीक है. ओके सर.
ओके, स्टार्ट करने की कोशिश में देखो, जब भी लाइक यू हैव डन. ओके, सो जस्ट टेल मी, वी कैन नेक्स्ट डे, नो प्रॉब्लम. ओके,
ओके सर, हम रिवाइज करेंगे.
हाँ प्लीज, आप सिर्फ कहाँ तक रिवाइज करना, मैसेज तक रिवाइज करना. एंड अगेन टुमारो वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द स्टेट्स. ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम.
ओके, ओके सर, थैंक यू.
ओके आकिब.
ओके सर, ठीक.
ओके, चलो बाय, टेक
केयर. थैंक यू सर.
डाउट लगे जस्ट कॉल मी, नो डाउट, नो इश्यूज. ओके,
ओके सर. ओके, ओके,
ओके, बाय.
बोलते रहो.
ओके, बाय.